Last time I was here was 2015, and I've seen a lot of change in the last 4 years. Like, it's just amazing how the city has evolved, the kind of restaurants it has, the kind of cuisine the city is serving, the kind of restaurant formats.
It has gone sea change.
Yeah.
Within 5 years.
I've seen a massive change. Like, I feel it's almost as good as any other top metropolitan city in the country. I think earlier it was very restrictive, where you, because you would only get local cuisine, which was amazing, but people didn't have many options, or people weren't willing to sort of experiment. But I see, like, there's everything in the city, and it's as you said, it's changing very quickly. So yeah, you have a question?
Yeah, I have one question.
Yeah.
What ingredient do you feel is the most underappreciated?
Oh, this is a tough one. I think there are so many Indian ingredients and spices that we never speak about or cook. Like, for instance, all the different kind of yams, or you know, different or sweet potato. We have so many such ingredients, whereas you only speak about one or two or three dishes.
The star dishes.
But I think Indian food is more about diversity, is about diversity, not only with flavors but also with ingredients, and I think that is something that we really need to sort of follow and work on.
I have a question. Since you're talking about local cuisine, what's your favorite South Indian food and why?
There's a, you know, South India is, can be divided into so many parts. It's a tough one, but yeah, if I had to pick onto one thing, I would say the lunch meals, or the mess sort of meals that we have, which is a typical banana leaf thali, whether it's Andhra or whether it's Tambram, or it could be a Keralian meal as well. But the lunch format, where they all cook their local vegetables, the lunch meals, sort of the thali, or the mess meal, if you were to call it, is my favorite South Indian meal.
So what are the trends in, say, Mumbai or Delhi, which are yet to catch up in Chennai?
I think one is, the biggest one which is slowly catching up here is gastropubs, because people in Delhi and Bombay especially are only going out to drink.
Yeah.
And eating is like a combination that they follow. But more and more restaurants now do a lot of drinks paired up with cuisines. It could be Indian, Italian, or French, but that's what the combination looks like. It's not just about food, and that's the massive change that I've seen in those two cities, and I think it's catching up here as well, but it's slow. And I think we're keeping it, both the cities are now following this format of keeping it local. So it's I think that's what I've not seen in Chennai, unless it's happening and you can correct me.
There are a few restaurants, but the trend is slowly catching up. I think Bangalore is much more.
Bangalore is only drinking and no eating.
Yeah. So yeah. I came from Bangalore, so it was a little cultural shock for me. And I mean, cuisine wise also. But now it has picked up quite well.
Also, because we're talking about Chennai and flavors, so one of the things that I'm doing today in my masterclass, you were told to take inspiration from ingredients in Chennai, or what you have eaten or what you've had on this trip. And the dish that I'm making is actually a beet muruku with chicken 65 and sundal hummus.
Oh,
So I'm like taking all the local inspirations, and also because we sort of judge things on 3 or 4 parameters. There's innovation, there is health, there is taste, of course, the prime one out of that, and plating being the fourth pillar. So we're making it healthy by using Philips air fryer. So the Morocco, instead of deep frying, I'm putting it in the air fryer to see if it if it's as crisp as you would do it originally. And soon we'll be making a hummus, and we're serving it like a snack.
Okay.
So it should be a lot of fun.
One question.
Yeah, sure.
So I have the Philips air fryer, and most of us are pure vegetarians here.
Yeah.
So apart from French fries, that I'm just making only that in my air fryer.
Yeah.
Can you suggest something simple, nice?
So you know what I mostly use it for is I do roasted beets, beetroot. I do roasted vegetables overall. Okay. So I think roasts work really well. If you do chips, like beet, again, yam,
sweet potato.
So you can also do like interesting, healthier snacks which are not just French fries, you know. So I think that works really well. You can bake cakes.
I try cashew nuts and roasted.
Yeah, that is nice. Yeah.
I got a specific question for you. Between your first love, which was acting, and your profession as a leading Indian chef to take Indian cuisine global, which is your favorite? I mean, which is close to your heart between these?
I've realized that because I'm somebody who likes to explore a lot, somebody who travels a lot, I've sort of learned that travel is the best teacher. And I like sharing my knowledge with people, and I do feel like whether it's food or my travel experiences or my journey, the fact that I can share with people by being an entertainer will always be my first love, which is to learn and then give it back to the community. So my passion for acting is more sort of stage oriented, where I like talking to people, I like having a conversation, I like having a discussion around what I saw, what I learned. And that is where I sort of use my theatrical skills to say.
So you get a platform and you manage to.
Yeah, I manage to, because I think when you can take a hobby and make it into a profession, how do you make sure it's still your passion? I think you have to sort of marry 2 or 3 things that you like together to live it up and to sort of have a longer shelf life with that profession.
Is there any particular South Indian dish that you were really interested in that you tried recreating there in your some time?
I think what we did once was these paniyarams that you get. I did a chocolate paniyaram, which is one of my favorite combinations that I tried, and it turned out really well. So yeah, I think that's my first memory of taking something South Indian and playing with it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thanks guys. Thank you so much.